Ooh, a lot of pressure here. Yeah. You miss, you lose it all.
Stay out of my head. And you know you have a distinct advantage with the smaller hands, right? Mm. Your goalposts are not as big.
Well, I guess you should have married Uma Thurman.
Yeah, that would have been great. There's a snap. Here's the hold.
Oh!
And a text. That was interference.
Sorry, honey, I know how much that meant to you.
Come on.
Dr. Chen is ready for you.
Great.
I think we've determined why you've been having trouble conceiving.
Okay, let's have it.
Great.
Oh, what's that look? Is it me? Of course it's me.
I'm not loving your semen.
Oh?
Your count is excellent, but your motility is well below normal.
That's too bad.
What would cause that?
It can be genetic, environmental factors. 9 times out of 10, though, it's psychological. Mm. Have you been feeling anxious or stressed?
No, I don't think so. Not really.
He's always a little stressed.
Well, you don't have to write. I'm not. Honey, she's writing it down.
Well, Max is very competitive, as am I.
We sure are.
And the reasons I fell in love with him. Maybe that makes him a little more prone to stress than normal people.
Normal people?
How long has this been going on, Max?
It's not going on.
Oh, well, you did say even when you were a kid, you would freak out if you lost at anything.
Oh, I was a kid.
Especially if you lost your brother.
Hmm.
Hey, is that what this is?
No.
You have been so uptight since you found out that Brooks is coming to town. I mean, could that be a factor in all of this?
Let's be fair.
Sibling rivalry can be very powerful. Cain and Abel, the Baldwins.
The what?
The brothers.
I'm not sure why we're discussing this. She's not a therapist. You're not a therapist, right? With all respect.
Well,
no, but I am a doctor, and I believe in treating the whole patient. So what is it about your brother that makes you feel emasculated?
Are we gonna do this? And we're right next to the room where I masturbated.
I think he has it in his head that Brooks is cooler and more successful and hotter than he is.
I never said hotter.
He's charming.
It's interesting. And is he single?
What's that?
Oh, I don't know if I mentioned it, but Keith and I are on a trial separation.
Keith.
Keith.
So do you think your brother would want to grab a cup of coffee with me?
Gosh, I don't know.
Well, it doesn't hurt to ask.
Hurts a little.
No. Is he a tall fella? Because I'm only 5'2".
We're all done with my semen.
He is taller than Max.
Good.
But he did date this ballerina once, and she was just teeny tiny little
thing. Ooh. Honey, Gary, don't mention game night, okay?
Mm-hmm. Good evening,
hey.
Max.
Gary.
Annie.
Hello there.
Hi, Gary.
Just checking the mail.
Oh, yeah?
Some people check it earlier in the day, but there's always a risk that the mail carrier hasn't come yet. This spares me the chance of a futile trip to the mailbox.
Uh-huh.
Plus, it allows Bastion here the opportunity to urinate.
You have a good one.
Any plans for this evening?
No.
Perhaps a game night?
You're just gonna stay in, just the two of us.
Mm-hmm.
Boring.
Mm. I see. I do hope you keep me in mind for any future game nights.
Well, you bet.
I've always enjoyed the camaraderie of good friends, competing in games of chance and skill.
Yeah. Yeah, well, we'll do that, but it's nice just two of us.
Oh, you two enjoy each other. It's often we don't appreciate what we have until it's gone.
I think that's it.
Okay, bye-bye. If Gary sees the others coming, we're screwed.
No, honey, it's not gonna be a problem. I was very, very clear with everyone to park far away and just to sneak in quietly, you know? Well, now, I mean, you don't think we're being d***s, do you? I mean, should we just still invite the guy? He really seemed like he wanted to play.
No, no. Debbie was our friend, and Gary was just the creepy husband that we had to put up with.
That's true.
He's only gotten worse since the divorce.
Yeah, we don't owe him anything, right? F*** him.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi.
Can we help you? I'm okay.
Hey!
Of course. Ryan, why are you coming in through the window?
You said sneak in so RoboCop wouldn't see us.
I meant sneak in through the door.
Oh, you were super vague.
I wasn't vague at all.
What?
No, I didn't say break the succulents.
I did not dress for this nonsense. This is ridiculous.
It's like Night of the Living Dead in here.
Yeah, you are asking a lot from us,
I didn't say to come through the window.
This is Max. We used to work together. His wife, hey. Annie, Michelle, and that guy.
The door,
Kevin.
Right, buddy.
Guys, this is Madison.
Yeah, you brought her last week. You work at Forever 21, right?
No.
I work at Sephora.
I'm confused.
Different girl. Same look, same voice.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
What's yours?
That's a...
No, I think you're supposed to kiss it, right? Mm. Welcome.
Do you guys have a bathroom?
There's one just down the hall. You need it?
Okay, is it on the right or the left? I don't want to go in the wrong room.
The one with the toilet.
Can't miss
okay.
it.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Dude.
Oh, wow.
Right?
Where'd you find her, a TED Talk?
No, at Chipotle.
Let me ask you something, Ryan. Aren't you sick of losing gang night every week because of the dates you bring?
They're not always that bad. Heather, seriously, how many photos of you with the dog filter do you need?
Dennis isn't a word.
Oh, yeah, it is. It's my daddy's name, so.
Okay, unlike you psychos, I don't give a shit about winning game night. I don't need that validation.
But you do need the validation of dating Instagram models.
Absolutely. I'm sorry. I'm not like you, Michelle. We didn't all meet our soulmate when we were 10 years old.
14.
Oh, sorry, 14.
And we didn't get married until we were 19.
That's gross.
You know what, Ryan? I hope one day you get to meet a lovely young lady so you can love her as much as I love my
yes,
sweet baby right now.
Yes, find her. Look at this. Look so at much this. Love.
Let's look at it when we do it.
Hey, everybody, grab your drinks. Let's go play. Come on.
Dude, do you know what rich people are doing on their game nights these days?
What's that?
Fight clubs.
What?
I just read about them. They pay poor people to fight each other and then they bet on the winner.
No, that's not a real thing.
Yes, it is. If you can have anything you want in this world, you have to raise the stakes or life gets boring. The Kennedys used to have fight clubs at their compound.
Honey, listen, you gotta stop reading BuzzFeed every second of the day.
How about some charades? Huh? Should we start with charades?
Yeah,
no! Hey!
Do you want to wait for Brooks?
I don't think we need to. No, he's late.
Wait, hold up. Brooks is in town?
Yeah. I thought he was working in Europe.
He was, yeah. He's apparently back for some business. Haven't seen him yet. We can get started. Who wants to start?
Who are you guys talking about?
Max's brother. He's this super successful venture capitalist.
Yeah, he was the first to invest in Panera Bread. Mm-hmm. You know, the Fuji apple salad was his idea.
A lot of investors. Yeah.
He's like the Mark Wahlberg to Max's Donnie.
Well.
Which is a huge compliment because Donnie was f***ing great in The Sixth Sense, wasn't he?
He was.
Is he in The Sixth Sense?
He sure is, yeah. You know who's not in The Sixth Sense? Mark Wahlberg.
Mark would never take a role that small.
Is that right? Madison.
Man, I haven't seen him since the wedding. Oh, remember
yes.
that speech he gave?
So oh, and then he paid for that whole fireworks display.
Oh my gosh, oh, the fireworks.
Let's get started. I'm gonna start us off.
Let's
start us off. Here we go.
All right.
Let's do it.